Amphion has published an update to their zero-shot voice cloner, Vevo. Vevo 1.5 is more than just speech-to-speech conversion. It attempts to do singing voice conversion as well. And just a forewarning, I am narrating this video using Vevo 1.5, so you can get a better idea of what it sounds like, even with all of its flaws. As you already probably heard, it seems that its phoneme detection is a little bit off. You might want to turn on subtitles just in the case some of my words get too garbled to understand. You may also notice that it sounds a little bit crunchy, and that's because it's processed at 24 kHz, which is really half the sample rate you should be doing for voice conversion. I understand why they do this, because processing at a higher rate requires more computing power, but it's a little bit disappointing all the same. Anyway, Vevo has several influence modes. The one you're hearing right now is FM synthesis. It just takes in a voice, in this case Martin Sheen as reference, and whatever audio you wish to convert, in this case it's my voice speaking into a microphone, and basically acts as a voice changer. Now the cool part about it is that the reference voice is only 15 to 30 seconds long, and you don't have to worry about training a model, it just outputs everything instantly. But the previous version of Vevo already did plain speech-to-speech synthesis. This is a singing voice conversion model more than anything. So let's check out some singing voices. Here I've got isolated vocals of Elvis singing Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas!
And I've got a recording of me singing along with altered vocals. I'll spare you my horrible off-pitch, boy. But the important part to note is that I tried to match the timing of what Elvis was saying and not so much the pitch, because when I run it through AR and FM recognition synthesis, my reference melody is Elvis. It doesn't have to be someone singing. In fact, the Bertin Vevo example uses a piano. You can actually specify the voice print and the melody separately, but in this case, I'm using Elvis for both. Anyway, here's what it sounds like when my voice is transformed into Elvis's pitch and timbre.
Vevo got an update. Vevo, Vevo got an update.
And just for fun, let's put it all together with the music and backing vocals.
Vevo got an update. Vevo, Vevo.
But we can go even further beyond. It doesn't have to be Elvis's voice. It can be anybody's voice with Elvis singing the tune. So here in this example, I've changed out the timbre reference with Dolly Parton.
Just when I've begun to get myself together, you walked right in the door.
I've clicked the Elvis voice as the reference melody, and the reference style is just me again on the microphone with different lyrics.
I like cheeseburgers. I like cheeseburgers.
All right, so now that you have an idea of how it works, you probably want to know how to run it. A good place to start is the Amphion repository, of course. Just keep in mind that this repository is actually a bunch of different projects all wrapped into one. It's kind of a mess, but it's located under Models SVC Vevo Sing. The main problem with this is that the demos are hard-coded, so it's a little bit unwieldy to run these. You have to edit the Python code and stuff like that. So I made a tool that makes it a little bit easier. I just took their reference code and made a simple GUI that allows you to select the different options. It's not fancy, but it gets the job done. I made this originally for the first version of Vevo, and then I updated it just recently to support 1.5. Special thanks to GUUser91 for helping me test out some of these changes. He's also the person that let me know about the update very quickly after it came out, so I was able to meet all this stuff done within a week of Vevo 1.5's release. Now, one thing to keep in mind when you are using Vevo is that it is not designed for long clips. You should really be using very short clips, like 15 seconds at most. That can get very tedious very quickly when you want to do something longer. So I solved that problem in another project I have called Redubber. Now, this is a command line utility. I don't recommend it for everyone, but basically what the utility does is chunk up the audio into bot-sized segments separated by silence. Then it operates on each segment individually and then reassembles the audio back into the original length clip. It can do this not just for audio, but for video as well. Now, it's set up to be more of an automatic process, so it doesn't allow to tweak every little thing, so just keep that in mind. Now that we've got all of that out of the way, let's talk about some of the downsides of Vevo 1.5. I've already mentioned the phoneme detection thing. It's just a little bit off, and it's just enough to be too annoying to use for regular use coasts. I'm not exactly sure why this is. Vevo 1 was just fine. I did a cursory search of the repository for Hubert, which is the phonemization model that is used by most people to figure out which sounds make up different words and stuff. And it looks like Vevo 1 does use Hubert, but Vevo 1.5 does not. So that could be one explanation there. Another problem, at least with AR and FM synthesis, is that it requires a transcript to go along with the reference audio. It's not entirely clear to me why it needs these transcripts, and if the transcript for your reference style, it is not the same as the transcript for your reference output, it kind of just mixes up all the words and you sometimes get absolute nonsense.
In the Boladries, praise me, the Kratners, oh, the beat do's fall. If it ought to lead a rassy heart needy.
So yeah, is this a perfect tool? No, not by a long shot. I actually just kind of think it's barely usable. Recording voice lines for this has been kind of a nightmare, and I will not be doing that again. You may already be annoyed at listening to some of these little vocal glitches, but this is the best output out of multiple takes. And I am trying to enunciate far more clearly than I usually do. Anyway, it's still a fun little toy to mess with, and I hope they keep working on it and improving it in the future. I'm really more fascinated in the idea of it more than the execution, and considering this project started less than 6 months ago, I'm willing to give it a break. I mean, just take a look at early Stable Diffusion and tell me that wasn't rough. So if you like checking out weird, janky stuff just because it's fun, give Vevo a try. At least you'll get a chuckle or two out of it. I know I did. But at any rate, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching, and have a nice day.